If you're a concealed carry holder and you're taking responsibility and carrying every day, that can be a real challenge to find the perfect holster. Whether it's something like this little Ruger LCP, or Glock 19, or a 1911, whatever it is. But today we're going to take a look at a lot of different holster options, but we're specifically going to look at more compact or subcompact sizes. Now, larger pistols, because of their size, tend to be limited to where you can carry them. Inside the waistband, outside the waistband. Some of them can go into a ankle holster, something like that. But really, with these smaller pistols, there's a lot more deep cover options. You know, guys, I know one of the things about carrying a pistol every day is sometimes there are situations where I need to go light, small, and very discreet. And there are other times where, you know, I'm wearing a jacket, I'm out and about, I need something a little bit larger. It's just easier to conceal. Now, if you carry a handgun for self-protection on a daily basis, you know that there are a lot of factors that go into having the right holster. And there's a lot of preferences. Some people like to have a strap to go over it. Some like retention. But this is really mainly going with very small pistols, more of your smaller single stacked or even subcompact pistols. And when I say subcompact, I'm talking more about, you know, the Ruger LCP, Smith & Wesson J-Frame. The largest I've got here is a Glock 43, the C-Camp 32 that I like to carry. These are really the kind of pistols that I like to have when I just need to be discreet, when I need to go somewhere that I just want to feel very comfortable. Maybe it's more of a formal type situation, or maybe, you know, it's a place that I just don't want to print. And so there's a lot of different options out there, but finding the right one can be a little tough. Now, what we're going to do today, though, is just go through some holsters. I'm going to show you some different ones. This isn't all-inclusive for sure. I mean, there's a whole bunch of different types. And some of these are no longer produced, which, you know, that's going to be an issue as well. But it'll at least give you some ideas on what might work for you. Now, we're going to start out with the Ruger LCP because I have so many options for this pistol. It's so small, it makes it really great for deep cover or discreet carry. First thing I want to do, though, is double check, make sure the gun's unloaded. Now, all the guns that I'm going to be showing are unloaded, but just for safety's sake, I wanted to go through this one. The one thing about this pistol is because it's so small, you know, it can easily go into a pocket holster. And here we have one. It's just a really soft, inexpensive holster. It's man-made material. This part at the bottom is a sticky, tacky type feel to it. So when you put this into your pocket, it stays, whereas the pistol will come right out. It'll slide right out. And the material inside here is made that way to keep it really slick. It's kind of almost like a velour or suede. But this way, the pocket stays, it retains the holster. Now, one of the things about a small holster like this, rather than just putting a pistol in your pocket, and I've done that before just for various reasons, but it will turn and it will fall, and typically because of the slides heavy, this will end up being in your pocket. So when you reach down to grab it, you know, you've got to orientate it into a certain position, and too, with the safety factor of the trigger. Even though that this is a double action striker fired pistol, it's not necessarily going to be easy to pull that trigger, but in a critical situation it could. So I highly recommend having a holster regardless. Now, here's another one of the lesser expensive holsters, and this one actually is a little different. It has this hook, so when you're retrieving your pistol, the hook catches on your pants and it'll hold the holster and retain it into place. One thing this one has is some of that material right here to give it a little more traction on the inside of your pocket. So again, very inexpensive, but yet very effective. I've used these holsters for a good while. And again, this one will also fit a number of different size pistols. This is a great little inside the waistband holster option. It is DeSantis. It's suede, and then you have your leather on top. I like this clip, the way it fits into the belt. And then, of course, you can tuck your shirt in. So this, to me, is really a great way to carry one if you want to carry it inside the waistband. Of course, my favorite pocket holster is this Cayman exotic leather holster. This was made by Jackson Leatherwork. In fact, when I told him I wanted one of these, he said, "Are you sure you want that nice, beautiful leather in your pocket where nobody can see it?" But I know it's there and I love it. But this is a beautiful holster. And of course, it has the little hook here. So when you're pulling it out, the holster remains, it retains the holster, and you can pull this right out and do what you're doing. One of the big things too about having a holster is that it kind of covers any kind of printing. You will have your grip here, but it covers that up, so it's not very easy to tell that this is a firearm. And here I have just an outside-the-waistband holster. I know it's a clip and it's almost like a left-handed. You could use it for an inside-the-waistband left-handed. But this one actually clips onto the belt, and because the gun is a very small gun, it doesn't, you can pull this out without this pulling the holster off. So it's an outside-the-waistband. Now, I haven't worn this one a lot because I don't typically wear this one on the inside, but it is an option. And that's one of the things, guys, that I really like, is having a number of options for the guns that I'm going to carry on a regular basis. And really, if this clip was on the other side, this would also be a great inside-the-waistband option. One of the things about this holster in a right-hand inside-the-waistband is one of my everyday carries. In fact, my Glock 26 is in my Jackson Leatherwork inside-the-waistband holster. I wear this thing every day. And I mean, you can see how it's worn, but look how beautiful that becomes. It's one of the things about leather. With age, it just really softens up and it makes it really nice. This gun is loaded. Now, one option that I am very fond of is an ankle holster. And having this on your ankle, it makes it really difficult for anyone to tell that you have this wrapped around your ankle. This is a DeSantis Apache. And it has this kind of a fake sheepskin right here that really makes the difference. I've had some of these, this material here that wraps around your leg, and it just irritates it. But this really makes it simple. Just to give you a testimony of how comfortable this is, we were coming back from the range one day and I had an outside the waistband holster on and I had just a t-shirt. So I took my concealed carry off to go into the restaurant because we don't have open carry in our state. And my buddy that was with me, he was carrying his. So I ended up going in and eating lunch and everything. And it wasn't until I got back into my truck when I lifted my leg, I felt the weight of this holster. That is how comfortable this holster is. So it goes on your leg, it makes it really discreet, and this is to me one of the best options. Now this is something that's totally different, and in fact it's no longer in production from what I've found. This is called the Ghost Belt. This is a really cool idea. Now when I first heard about it, I couldn't even imagine, but it's a little almost like yoga pants, but it's a stretchy material and your firearm can go in here. And then here you can put a magazine. And this goes around your waist and it makes it so easy. Now, a lot of people say, well, I don't want to pull that zipper. Well, you can actually fire the pistol through this material. And the gun I use for this holster is my J-Frame Smith & Wesson. This is a Centennial, it's a 38. Now, I can set this in here and actually fire the revolver through the holster. So this makes it a really great option for the revolver specifically. If you have a semi-automatic, you could fire one round, but then the slide's going to come back. I've heard, though, that it'll function even with this material because it's so stretchy. But I keep a speed loader in this one, or a couple of speed loaders. And this has been an option for a good while when I want to carry my revolver, a 38 Special. But again, these that I don't think they're still being made, but it was called the Ghost Belt. Just a great little, you know, item, a great idea. Now for my 38 Special revolver, I do have a number of other holsters. These are just two that I grabbed. The Ghost is really what I use the most, just because it's just the way this thing's set up. But also, here we have a Don Hume. This is one of the inside the waistband holsters. These are pretty inexpensive, but they actually are pretty decent. And this one works well. I do have a G-code inside the waistband that I really like. It's Kydex. But a lot of times on the smaller pistols, I don't really go a lot with Kydex. I usually save that for the larger pistols, a little more rigidity, and this makes it a little more comfortable, a little easier because it's just kind of molded over. But there are a lot of options for the 38 Special. These are just two that I have. Now here we have my C-Camp 32. Guys, I'm going to tell you, this gun now has taken the place of the Ruger LCP because of its size. It is so much smaller. In fact, here are the two together. And there are just so many ways to be able to really make this deep cover or deep carry. And so this has really become my backup gun, or if I'm wanting to go light, I carry this and an extra magazine. One of the holster options that I got was from C-Camp, and this is their pocket holster. It's flat on the back, so when you put it into your pocket, it doesn't print at all, and yet it molds right into the holster, and there's a retaining piece right here, so it's not going to come flying out. This is a beautiful setup. These holsters are not really cheap, but neither is this pistol. This is a really top-notch handgun. And if you're looking for an ultra-small pistol, this to me is one of the best on the market. And it just gives you so many options. There are times where in the past I may have opted not to carry because I just couldn't print. This has really been a big plus in my concealed carry rotation, because no matter what, I can always carry this somewhere and nobody would even know it's there. Of course, John Jackson over at Jackson Leatherwork made me a beautiful ostrich leg leather holster. Man, that thing's beautiful. Inside the pocket, it matches this pistol the best. In fact, this is what I usually have. This goes in my front pocket, and it's just so nice. I mean, it fits so well. It's actually curved, so it just has that perfect way. Got the hook, so I'm catching again, but a really small package. But if I want to go cheaper, I can get one of these little small pocket holsters. It has the tacky material here, and slides this in. I think these are about $6-7. I mean, they're very inexpensive and actually hold up pretty well. So this is something, it's very soft, easy to carry in your pocket. This old Uncle Mike's holster, I've had this, obviously, for about 30 years, no kidding. Now, if you don't want to go super extravagant with an ostrich leg leather holster, you can go with something like this. This is just a standard leather holster from Jackson Leatherwork, and actually, we made this for a different pistol, but it fits this C-Camp. And that's the other thing about these type holsters. I can fit different pistols in here, even my little Beretta Jetfire. It's just a really nice little fit. Now, another holster option that's very popular is a belly band holster. This just fits around your waist with the Velcro, and you can close that up, and it makes it real secure. Rides it close under your shirt, and it doesn't come off easily. This particular model is from DeltecForce.com, which I get all of my leather belts from. Those guys are fantastic. But this has a lot of different options on it for as far as carrying different pistols. And here I can take, sit my pistol in, and then I can Velcro, and now I've got this retained. But here we have extra mag pouches on the sides. So this one to me is if you're ready for battle. We have four mag pouches here. We have another pouch over here, and even another gun pouch on this side. So this one has a lot of options, but go to DeltecForce.com and check out all the different belly bands. They also do the undercover t-shirts, which I have used that. I haven't used it in a while, but that is one thing that has a holster built in. The only problem is it seems to sag a little bit on me, and because I'm kind of a, you know, fairly slim stature, and so it does kind of ride a little bit out, and I have to be careful. But speaking of DeltecForce, he makes bull leather belts that are second to none. In fact, I wear them every day, and they are fantastic. And so really, you need to make sure you have a good belt. That's the platform for your holster system, even if it's in your pocket, because it's holding your pants up and it gives you a good platform. So DeltecForce.com, I'll have the information down below. Here is one of his suede pocket holsters. It's a pretty large holster, but you can fit a number of different size pistols in here. This is the Beretta Tomcat, so it's a not too small of a pistol, even though it's much more compact than most. But you can put it here, you can take your extra magazine and place it here, you can slide this in your back pocket, and then the back will take away any printing. So this is a great option. Plus, this is that suede, so it's going to retain itself in the pocket, and then you have your tanned leather here. So there are a lot of different options for these, a lot of different styles. Now, one pistol that I love to carry and forget that it's even there is one of these little North American Arms. You can get it in 22, 22 Magnum. There's a whole different number of different models for these pistols. This is one of their inside the waistband holsters, or inside the pocket, and just places here, and you can get it out really easily. It's very small. This is one also that is from Jackson Leatherwork, and you can put your pistol in here and a small knife or something like that in this little pouch, and this goes in your pocket. And this is a great little option, and of course it helps to mask that revolver look. Plus it keeps it orientated in the right direction. There are some pretty cool ones. I do have one that's a Kydex that fits over it, and then it has a neck ring, so I can wear this on my neck and pull it off if I need it. And I just didn't have it available.
But there are a lot of options for these little mini revolvers, and these are just a couple. Now guys, too, I mean, this is 22 long rifle, definitely very underpowered, but just like my buddy who's a federal marshal told me one time, he goes, this is my get off me gun. If you don't have anything else, this could save your life. And last but not least, I wanted to bring out my little baby Browning. This is something that I really don't carry that often. And if I do, it's definitely a backup or something in my pocket. Of course, the standard Jackson Leatherwork pocket holster, or any kind of pocket holster for that matter, makes it really nice, and it catches again. I mean, all the same things. It hides it a little bit, and it keeps it in the right orientation. Same thing with this very inexpensive little holster, pocket holster. It keeps it in the right orientation. This material will stay in your pocket, and again, it doesn't print. Those are the things you really need to be concerned about. And also, drawing with this material, it makes it really slick. So, while I don't recommend carrying something like this, you know, I do love little mouse guns, and sometimes people, this is all they have. I mean, this just happens to be the only thing that they have, or something this small. But guys, really, having a baby Browning 25 ACP in your pocket is better than having a 1911 45 ACP at home on your nightstand. So guys, don't forget the 1911 that's on your nightstand. And one thing too that's important is a mag carrier of some sort. If you slide this in your pocket, it's going to fall down. Now this one matches my Cayman pocket holster. This was also made by Jackson Leatherwork. In fact, this was a set. And then I've got my magazine in here, and I can put this just on my belt and have that extra magazine. But one of my favorite ways to carry an extra magazine is this extra carry. This is a concealed carry magazine. It's extracarry.com. These are great little mag carriers. In fact, it's almost like a little knife, has a little clip right here that fits on the outside of your pants or your outside of your pocket, and then you slip your magazine inside the carrier, and nobody knows it's there, and you know exactly where it is. This is a great little option, and again, I'll have the link down below on these, but extracarry.com. These are just neat, and they do them for all different size pistols. Now this is the largest pistol I'm going to talk about, the Glock 43. There's so many options for it, guys, and you know, there's just a ton of different ways you can carry this. Whether it's, you know, your leather holster like this inside the waistband, outside the waistband, Kydex, hybrid holsters. I mean, there are just so many things. One of the ways though that I carry it, and I just wanted to mention it, is just like this. Same as my Glock 26. Just an inside the waistband. It's really thin. And here we have one of the Don Humes, and this is a nice little holster, and I've had this one for a long time. Great holster, but the leather on this one is just so comfortable to wear. But I don't really want to get into this size that much because there are so many options, and this is something you'd be carrying as your primary. But I wanted to bring out these carriers again, the extra carry mag holder. Just great idea, this little clip, and just makes it really nice. You don't even know this is in your pocket. This is something, guys, for you to really take a look at. And for you, all you guys who go with Kydex, nothing wrong with that. I like Kydex too. That's just another type situation. But Kydex holsters are great, and I highly recommend them for a lot of different carry applications. Now guys, down in the comments below, if you have some holster choices that you found that really work for you, please leave them down in the comments. And it really makes it nice, whether it's the company, whether it's just the style. And being able to find the right holster will lend you to carrying more. Because guys, really, if you have a concealed carry, you need to be responsible. And when you're out, not only for you and your family, but also those around you. Be strong, be of good courage. God bless America. Long live the Republic. Because really, guys, if you're a concealed carry holder, the Smith & Wesson down, but what happens is, if you don't want to go too extravagant, here we've got more. This is actually the size of. You can slip this into your pocket
not only for you and yourself, whether it's an inside the waistband holster or an outside, whether it's Kydex or Lather. If you have a Lather holster, I want to see it.